Hi friends, today we will see fatigue analysis of the connecting rod. Here I selected an engineering material, and the material of this is aluminum alloy. The properties of the aluminum alloys are shown in this table. The density coefficient, thermal expansions, tensile and yield strength, alternative stress ratios. So these are alternating stress ratios. Here is cycles and alternating stresses in Pascal. So if the cycles are 1700, then stresses are 2.7 × 8 pascals. If the cycles increases, also the stresses value reduces up to 8.274 × 7. The purpose of this alternate stresses, when we apply the loading, fluctuating load in this aluminum alloy rod, so the alternate stresses generated during the loading should be less than this 8.27 at the cycle of E-strength. Then the material will be in safe condition, so our designing will be safe. So we have selected this material. Next is geometry. For the time being, I created the geometry. Here I can see this is connecting rod. In the model, I applied loads for different conditions, material assignment, machine. All this preparation of post-processing process will be done. The geometry, I select the aluminum alloy assignment, material assignment, machine. For the time being, I applied the normal machine to perform the analysis fastly. So I will use core sizing, threaded mesh, rugged mesh. It is coarse machine, so it will complete machine immediately. The tiny is more fine, so I use medium machine. So in statistic we can see the number of elements and nodes created. If I update this, then number of nodes and element will be increased. So now the nodes and elements increases. Before new mesh, number of nodes was 4,400 near about that. So now is 10,958 nodes, and elements are 6,100. So now meshing is done. In static structural, here we have to apply fixed boundary condition and force or load. So first we go for support, fixed support. Here I will apply fixed support. Apply. And load. I will apply bearing load. So in bearing load, direction is in this direction. Here is my problem that. So sorry, here I will apply force. So force in negative direction. I will apply compressive force. So select this surfaces. Two faces. And factor change to the component in x direction, so it is compressive, so apply negative sign. There about 900 newton. So load in this negative direction and magnitude is 900 newton. So here's the thick support and first apply. I mean solution model, we have to calculate the stresses, different stresses. And I also calculate fatigue tool, stress tool. So in fatigue tool, before the fatigue work, I have to calculate factor of safety, stress tool, here is factor of safety, safety factor. After that, I will use fatigue tool. In the fatigue analysis, there are four stress, main stress correction theories: SN1, SN curve, Goodman's theory, Soderberg theory, and Nygaardberg theory. So, according to our choice, for the engineers are using mostly zero-based theory for designing any connecting rod, pistons, and other non-structuring parts. Discrete time 1-7, stress life or strain life. According to mean stress theory, we are using stress theory. Here, in the Goodman's theory, it is endurance and ultimate. Here is a zero, yield, and ultimate strength. So in Goodman's, seen that it is increased from this. The green line shows the Goodman's theory curve. So it is increases and goes up, and after yield it comes to the yield. So double it different. It start from here and reach up to the yield point. Gerber theory similar. It's smoothly increases up to zero and comes back to the yield ultimate. Minutes stress theory curve. There are the variable R. So alternating stresses and the cycles. If the R changes minus 1 to plus 0.5, so for different R it will be changes like this. So I will use Goodman's theory. And the one cycle equal to one cycle. And then, okay. I also insert some life or safety factor. So I will use life. Also in safety factor in fatigue analysis. So this safety factor and this safety factors are totally different. This is a mechanical safety factor, means ultimate upon yield like that, and this safety factor is fluctuating safety factor. So all things are set. We are going to solve this equation module. Need some time because made in machine course. So the search results are completed. So first we need to calculate the stresses. Maximum stress generated here from this edges, safety factor, mechanical skills. It's minimum is 9.9, so it is in safe. Here it is. safety factor. So here safety factor is 4.6. So our compound is safe for fluctuating as well as mechanical loading, such as compressive loading. If I increase the load from the 900 to 1100 Newton, so it will change this. You will see. I will again solve the situation. Position, safe condition. Here before applying the 1100 Newton load, when I applied 900 Newton, the factor of safety in fluctuating condition is near about 4. Now it comes to the 3.8. So this way we can use fatigue analysis of the connecting rod. In next video, we will see the fatigue analysis of the piston. Thank you very much.